Hello, everybody. Michael from Red Chair Diaries on Monday, the January 16th. Oh, I don't have my watch on. 16th, I think. Or is it? I don't even know anymore. 16th or 17th. Anyway, Ted and I actually had the day off together. We don't get too many of those, and we have tomorrow off together, so that's good. I think we'll go see the Meryl Streep movie tomorrow. So we dropped into Walmart after we did some other shopping and had a lovely chicken lunch. And Ted wanted this one, so I got this one for him. This is the Mark Wahlberg Planet of the Apes, a lot of you dislike. But he doesn't buy too many movies, and so I just as well get it for $10, basically. And he'll enjoy that, and he'll enjoy the Rise of the Planet of the Apes. Now, the other two are bizarre. I either had a dream about this last night or was thinking about that. I haven't seen it around in any version, and I wanted it. Jesus Christ Superstar from 72 or 73, something like that. I went to the theater to see this with a girl from I knew that I think had her eyes on me, but I was not gettable. And we went to this, and I'm not a terribly religious person or anything, but I do like the music, and I do want to complete my set of Lloyd Webber movies. So I do have Evita, which I probably my favorite score of his. And I do have Phantom of the Opera, which I think is my favorite movie version of the three of these. But this score is quite fantastic, and this is a very, very interesting movie. Most or all of it filmed in, you know, the deserts around Israel, and I think that's a very, very interesting touch. But I really recommend this just for the music. I mean, just put it on. It's wonderful. Remember, it's the so-called rock opera. And Ted Neely, Jesus, he's still on the road doing it, or was he retiring last year maybe from it, in 2011? From going on the road, still playing that role, and still looking good. It's amazing. And the fellow, if I remember correctly, I think the fellow who played Judas, Pontius Carl Anderson might have been his name. I don't. There aren't any names on this here. So, yeah, he died, I think, about 5 years ago. But it's good. Now look at the packaging. This is the Universal 100. So this was only $10 for the DVD, and I took a chance that it'd be in widescreen because it didn't say on the back. And it is. And you know, I don't have to go get a DVD, okay, or a Blu-ray. But their packaging's very, very nice, because they do a timeline, and they you can't see it on this, but they have highlights of what was out at that point from 1912 on. And then you've got that nice poster from the movie. So I think the whole thing is fantastic. Lovely slipcase. It is quite an ordeal trying to get it out of the slipcase, because it's all sealed up and with those stickers. And then this is just, you know, DVDs they took from their, you know, basic library or warehouse. I don't think there's anything, nothing special. Just a repackaging job, and so what, right? And there's the movie. So, I think that's a good thing. Oh, you can tell who brought a lot of money into Universal, can't you? Steven Spielberg? And I almost got Schindler's List, thinking of Spielberg, because that was $10 too. They did have some Blu-ray 100s, but not too many, so I thought I'll take the DVDs. That's fine with me. Now, this is the amusing one. Imitation of Life, the two versions. Now, I'd seen the Lana Turner one. That's from, what, 59, 60, 61, something like that, 1959. And that's very famous. And then Claudette Colbert did one. And in this one, you actually get the digital copy if you want it. You do with the other one as well. And this is very, very nice. It's got both posters. That's the Lana Turner one. Claudette Colbert. And that one's in full screen, of course, and then the Lana Turner one's in widescreen, so I'm glad that they did that, because I could not get any indication on the box, because that's the back of the box. So it didn't really give you a chance to see that. You know, but you can see all of that on the DVD. On the back there. It tells you at the bottom. But this is nice. Another advertisement for Spielberg. So there's, I guess that's the original one. And then disc two, it doesn't even say, but anyway, there's disc two. So it's nice to get the two discs, isn't it? Like that, so. I'm very happy with these. Anyway, that is my little update. And I'll see you around the tube. Ted and I got back recently from lunch and a bit of grocery shopping. And I said I'd like to have some of the ice cream that he bought the other day. So I think this is candy cane ice cream. I said I wanted to put on a bit of hot gingerbread, which he wasn't willing to do because I was just being silly anyway. But isn't that nice? He did put a ginger snap and a chocolate. Can you see that? Such a clever boy. Oh.